Good evening. We welcome all who are joining from home tonight. We are pleased that you are with us in spirit. We respectfully ask that all cell phones be silenced. Tonight, we are celebrating the beginning of the Lenten season. I am Art Rankin, and our second lector is Ed Matavilij, and our leader of song is Regina Foglia. The Deacon of the Mass is Deacon Mace Mazzoni. Monsignor Michael McCormick is our principal celebrant. Our Lenten fish fries are being held on Friday evenings of Lent from 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. in the Monsignor Woods Hall. Stations of the Cross will be held on Friday evenings at 7 p.m. during Lent. On Saturday evening, the parish will be sponsoring a cash bingo fundraiser in the Monsignor Woods Hall. All are welcome. Tickets can be purchased at the rectory and on the parish website. Donations of raffle baskets are needed and can be brought to the rectory. Donations toward prizes are also welcomed and appreciated. Thank you for all of your participation. On Sunday evening at 7 p.m., we will be having our Taizé prayer around the cross. All are most welcome to come and experience an encounter with Christ in song and silence. Next Wednesday evening, we will have our Lenten Adult Faith Formation Series entitled No Greater Love, a biblical walk through Christ's Passion at 7 p.m. in the Monsignor Woods Hall. It will be preceded by a soup supper beginning at 6 p.m. All are welcomed and encouraged to come. As we prepare for Mass, the prayer for priestly vocations can be found in the inside cover of the blue prayer book. Please stand and let us pray. Father, in your plan for salvation, you provide shepherds for your people. Fill your church with the spirit of courage and love. Raise up worthy ministers for your altars and ardent but gentle servants of the gospel. Bless our archdiocese with numerous vocations to the sacred priesthood. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Our entrance hymn is number 132, Lord, Who Throughout These 40 Days, 132.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome. A special welcome to those who are joining us from their home. I'd like for all of us to join in our prayer, offering this Mass for our brothers and sisters who are suffering in Ukraine, praying that their suffering soon come to an end, that the war end, and the troops be removed from that free country. We also want to remember Rose Jones, for whom this Mass is being offered. As we begin our Mass, we will begin with the sign of the cross, and then we will not have the penitential rite. In lieu of the penitential rite, we'll have the blessing and the imposition of ashes. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may begin with holy fasting this campaign of Christian service, so that as we take up battle against spiritual evils, we may be armed with weapons of self-restraint. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Joel. Even now, says the Lord, return to me with your whole heart, with fasting and weeping and mourning. Rend your hearts, not your garments, and return to the Lord your God. For gracious and merciful is he, slow to anger, rich in kindness, and relenting in punishment. Perhaps he will again relent and leave behind him blessing. Offerings and libations for the Lord your God. Blow the trumpet, Zion, proclaim a fast, call an assembly, gather the people, notify the congregation. Assemble the elders, gather the children, and the infants at the breast. Let the bridegroom quit his room, and the bride her chamber. Between the porch and the altar, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep and say, spare, O Lord, your people, and make not your heritage a reproach, with the nations ruling over them. Why would they say among the peoples, where is their God? Then the Lord was stirred to concern for his land, and he took pity on them and all his people. The word of the Lord. Reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are ambassadors for Christ, as if God were appealing through us. We implore you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake he made him to be sin, who did not know sin, so that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Working together then, we appeal to you not to receive the grace of God in vain. For he says, in an acceptable time I heard you, and on the day of salvation I helped you. Behold, now is a very acceptable time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, take care not to perform righteous deeds in order that people may see them. Otherwise, you will have no recompense from your heavenly Father. When you give alms, do not blow a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, to win the praise of others. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your almsgiving may be secret, and your Father, who sees in secret will repay you. When you pray, do not be like the hypocrites who love to stand and pray in the synagogues and on street corners so that others may see them. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you pray, go to your inner room, close the door, and pray to your Father in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will repay you. When you fast, do not look gloomy like the hypocrites. They neglect their appearance so that they may appear to others to be fasting. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, anoint your head and wash your face so that you may not appear to be fasting except to your Father who is hidden. And your Father who sees what is hidden will repay you. The Gospel of the Lord.
And so we begin this holy season of Lent. And very shortly, those who are here in church will come forward to receive the ashes on your forehead. It's important to know why it is that we do this. It's to remind us that sometime in the future, in God's time, we're going to die. That is not something that we like to think about, but it is true. And so the placing of the ashes should assist us in refocusing our lives. Over the years, I've enjoyed watching some of the older programs, those that were produced in the 70s and 80s. And as I watch them, I'm lulled into thinking that these people are still very young, when the reality is that many of them have already died. And every once in a while on the internet, they will show some of these great stars from years ago, then and now. Can't help but think how they've changed. Of course, people would say the same about ourselves. I do not look anything like I did when I was ordained to the priesthood 41 years ago, even 10 years ago. But we are changing and we are moving. Indeed, everything is changing. And so it's important that we come together tonight to begin this holy season of Lent and be reminded of what is important in our lives. In today's gospel, we hear of the three pillars of Lenten practices: fasting, prayer, and almsgiving. Our Holy Father, Pope Francis, has asked us, the Universal Church, to make the intention of fasting for our brothers and sisters in Ukraine, and pray God that we do that, that we offer the sacrifice for them, as so many of them are making the ultimate sacrifice out of love for their country and love for one another. Almsgiving, another great practice, not only during Lent, but every day, to recognize that we are blessed, we're gifted, and we're called to share that which we have received, and to do it intentionally in prayer. And maybe just for a few moments, reflect on prayer. Imagine for a moment a dear friend, someone you love and you trust. And imagine that you want to be with that person because you have something very, very important to share with them. Maybe it's anxieties, worries that you carry. Maybe we need to apologize to them for some hurt that we inflicted. Maybe it's good news we want to share, but whatever it is, there's something we want to share with that particular person. Now think, where would we want to share that? Certainly not in a crowded room, not in the middle of a party, not in anywhere that's noisy. We'd want to find a nice, quiet place where we could have an intimate conversation and share that which is in our hearts. My brothers and sisters, prayer is identical to that. It is having that intimate conversation with our God who loves us, whom we can trust, who knows us. Someone once said that prayer is spending time with God. And that's what it is. We don't have to worry about what words we choose, how it's going to be heard, because God loves us and he knows our hearts. But many of us find it difficult to pray, mainly because of our busyness. Just can't find the time. Time for everything else. Time for our cell phones, the internet, videos. But so often we don't find enough time to pray. And sometimes it's because we're disappointed in God, maybe even angry with him, because we have spent time praying, speaking to him, listening to him. And even though we've prayed, perhaps a little girl has died, even though we prayed. Maybe we're disappointed in what's happening and outraged even what's happened to our brothers and sisters in Ukraine. We wonder where God is. Our own country, so often in chaos and division. And so we say to ourselves, why even bother? And yet the truth is, and we know this, that when you have that friend, that person who loves us and we trust, how much better we feel when we're able to speak from our heart to that person, even if they cannot change any of it. We are lifted in spirit. It's liberating and renews us. God wants to do that for us, even though we don't understand his plan. And so often it's wrapped in mystery. And so we're going to have this quiet time with our friend, and we'll find the place. It's that important. Where do we look for a place to speak with God? Hopefully in our own homes, somewhere quiet, without any noise, without the phone. Maybe in our bedroom. But we also have here at St. Francis Cabrini our chapel, the St. Joseph Chapel, in our parish center. And we can go and pray there before the Blessed Sacrament.
where Jesus is present sacramentally. And so I began by saying, imagine meeting with a friend. Well, with God, we don't have to imagine. He is there. He is here. And he invites us to be with him. And so as we continue in the liturgy and begin the holy season of Lent, knowing that it is 40 days, not just one night, perhaps we can make a commitment to him tonight before we leave Mass here tonight. Make a commitment that we're going to make the time, carve it out, and spend time with our God. The Lord promises us that it will be liberating, and we will be able to move forward in our lives, not just during Lent, with a deeper and closer relationship with the God who created us, Jesus Christ, who has redeemed us. What a great invitation we have. The question always is, will we accept it? Please stand now for the blessing of the ashes and the imposition of the ashes. My brothers and sisters, let us humbly ask God our Father that he be pleased to bless with abundance of his grace these ashes which we will put on our heads in penitence. O God, who desired not the death of sinners, but their conversion, mercifully hear our prayers, and in your kindness be pleased to bless these ashes which we intend to receive upon our heads, that we, who acknowledge that we are but ashes and shall return to dust, may, through a steadfast observance of Lent, gain pardon for sins and newness of life after the likeness of your risen Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Please join in singing number 114, Ashes to Ashes, 114.
Thank you.
Please stand for the general intercessions. My brothers and sisters, trusting in the Lord's mercy, we bring our prayers to him.
For the church throughout the world, gathered in penance today, that in this season of renewal, all the faithful might be ambassadors of Christ, for Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those in authority may seek the ways of justice, so that the peoples of the world may be united in peace and harmony. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the citizens of Ukraine and Russia, for global leaders as they navigate geopolitical tension, for an ending of the war, for withdrawal of troops from Ukraine, and for peace throughout the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all present here today, that we may have the will to change our lives and the lives of others by our charity, good example, and prayer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, religious life, especially from among our St. Francis Cabrini Parish community, and may all those who are called respond with confidence and joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who work in our hospitals and all those who look after the sick and the elderly may be blessed with the quality and dignity of life which they bring to those in their care. That all first responders who endanger their lives to protect us will have the graces they need in life, threatening situations, and for all veterans, that they receive the care, comfort, and affirmation they need and so deserve. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick or suffering in any way, that they may know the presence and comfort of the Lord, we especially pray for Rocco Botafaco, Nicholas Corrado, Casey Eisenbray, Mark Gravante, Tom Holden, Kathleen McCormack-Diller, Joe Gillen, J.T. Nuttall, Eleanor LaRosa, Dennis Pierce, and Greg Schaefer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those saddened by the death of family or friends, may find comfort in Christ, and that those who have gone before us in faith now rest in the arms of Christ. We especially pray for Diana Kourish, Danica Mulholland, and Charlotte Stelma. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also remember and commend to the Lord Rose Jones, that she too be received into the kingdom and be at peace forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear these prayers which we bring before you and answer them according to your holy will. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 461, Be Still and Know That I Am God, 461.
You are my chosen one to whom I love.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we solemnly offer the annual sacrifice for the beginning of Lent, we entreat you, O Lord, that through works of penance and charity, we may turn away from harmful pleasures and cleansed from our sins, may become worthy to celebrate devoutly the passion of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord. Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, for you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and help us imitate you in your kindness. And so, we glorify you as we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, as we especially pray for our brothers and sisters in Ukraine. And all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar and high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. As we especially remember the Ukrainians and the Russians who have died in the war, and Rose Jones. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy
that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We invite those who are participating with us from their home and therefore not able to physically receive Holy Communion to please join us in praying the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Our communion hymn will be number 664, Loving and Forgiving. 664. Number 664, Loving and Forgiving.
Loving and forgiving.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received sustain us, O Lord, that our Lenten fast may be pleasing to you and be for us a healing remedy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Thank you for coming and celebrating Mass tonight.
A wonderful way to begin the Lenten season. I'm sure the Lord is very, very pleased that you're here. We had a wonderful congregation at 9:30 this morning. So I thank you for your presence and your participation here tonight. We have here at the table right in front of me little packets of ashes for those who might want to take them home for the homebound. Please feel free to come forward to do that. And I think one pack would be enough for each person that's taking them. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow down for the blessing.
Pour out a spirit of compunction, O God, on those who bow before your majesty, and by your mercy, may they merit the rewards you promise to those who do penance, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Our recessional hymn is number 117, Ashes 117.